Hello, welcome students. I am Mr. Sandeep here. So in the manufacturing technology, we have been going through the chapter foundry technology, and in the foundry technology or casting processes, in today's session we are going to discuss on different casting defects. So let us start our today's session, which is based on different casting defects, right? So in the earlier session, we have been going through the process of casting and brief introduction of casting process, right? So in the casting process, there are many defects which will come into picture after your final inspection of product. So if something went wrong, there are many casting defects which comes into picture, right? So let us start our today's discussion on different casting defects. So in the casting process, your purpose is to make the liquid metal. After that, you have to pour your liquid metal in the cavity. After that, your final product will be ready after solidification, right? So during solidification and during the pouring, if something went wrong, then your final casting will not be perfect one, and some defects will be there in the casting, right? So let us start our discussion on different casting defects. So here I mention the first defect, that is known as a misrun, right? So as per the name misrun, it is the defect in the casting. And how and why this type of misrun will come into picture? Let us start our discussion. What happens sometimes you pour your liquid metal, and what happens? Sometimes your liquid metal will flow to the different parts and different section of your final mold or cavity. At that time, what happens? At some section, solidification will start and your pouring will not be completed yet. So at that time, what happens? At some section, your metal will start solidifying and you kept on pouring your liquid metal. It means your solidification will start before completely filling of your mold cavity. At that time, this type of defect will come into picture. It means your metal will solidify at some section and you kept on pouring your liquid metal. So at that time, misrun will come into picture. So this defect is known as misrun, and the main cause for this misrun is a low pouring temperature or slow pouring. It means it will take more time than expected time, right? So this is undesirable. It means you have to avoid this type of defect in the casting with proper mold or proper getting system design, right? So here I mentioned the misrun defect and image for the product with the misrun, right? So let's have a look on the next one, that is the cold shot. So cold shot is defect which is found in the casting. And what is the main cause for the cold shot? So when two streams of liquid metal will start flowing towards each other, and what happens if they do not fuse properly and do not mat properly, this type of defect will come into picture. Once again I repeat, what happens when two stream of liquid metal, so in the some casting, if the geometry is casting, like when two liquid stream of metal while filling travels towards each other, and if it will not fuse or melt properly or mat properly, this type of defect will come into picture and known as a cold shot. So I mentioned in this image cold shot defect and a product with cold shot, right? Next defect here I mentioned is a shrinkage cavity. So here I mentioned in this image the shrinkage cavity defect. So this is the defect which come into picture due to the shrinkage, because all metal will shrink or contract in volume during solidification. So at that time what happens, if your metal will contract, there will be a shrinkage cavity, and it is known as a defect, shrinkage cavity as shown here, right? So it is the shrinkage cavity defect. After that, here I mentioned the micro porosity, which is also a defect. So micro porosity means it is a porosity found on surface of the casting. This is the localized contraction or localized solidification shrinkage at the surface, which is not desirable. So as per the name, it is a porosity or empty space found on the surface of casting, which is defect micro porosity, right? The next defect is hot tearing. So here I mentioned in this slide hot tearing defect. So what do you mean by hot tears? So hot tears means it is the irregular geometry found on surface, and this is by contraction or say ununiform contraction of your liquid metal, right? So this defect is not desirable, and this defect will come into picture due to not naturally shrinkage of your liquid metal. So this defect is due to metal's inability, or when your metal will not shrink naturally, this type of irregularity will come into picture, and this is known as a hot tears on the surface, right? So after that, the defect I mentioned is the blowhole or pin holes, right? So it is also known as the sand blowholes and pin holes, right? So as per the name, it is the defect which will come into picture in the casting, and it is shown as a small spherical cavities or small spherical holes. As per the name, it is a pin hole, right? So this type of defect is found on the surface of casting, and it is known as a pin holes. So why this type of defect will come into picture? So what happens when your permeability of sand is not proper or permeability is very low? What happens when you pour your hot liquid metal? The hot gases will try to escape through your sand, and if your sand is not porous enough, what happens? This type of hot gases will try to escape from your final product or liquid metal, and due to this bubble, what happens? Small pin holes will come into picture on the surface. So permeability of sand is the important parameter, and if it is not in the limit or as per your expectation, this type of defect will come into picture, right? So this is known as a pin hole. After that, I mentioned the sand wash. As per the name, if you pour your liquid metal and due to the pressure of your liquid stream, if your sand wall is damaged, it is known as a sand wash. So this is very simple. If your sand wall will be washed out or erosion occur, this type of defect will come into picture, known as a sand wash, right? So after sand wash, I mentioned the defect that is known as a scab. So what do you mean by scab? So as per the name, here I mentioned in this image the scab defect. So sometimes what happens when you pour your liquid metal, what happens? Your sand particle will come in between your metal particles during solidification, or in simple words, your sand particles will be embedded in your metal surface. So what happens at that time? Your final or your upper surface of casting will not be of metal only. There will be a sand particles found on the upper surface which is embedded in your metal. So this defect is known as a scan. This is not desirable for any finished casting, right? Because your casting surface or wall should be made of metal only. There should not be a sand particle embedded in between, right? So after that, I mentioned the mold sift. So as per the name, if two part of mold, that is known as a cock and drag sift, what happens? This type of defect will come into picture. So when you pour your liquid metal, your final product will not be exactly edge to edge. It will sift like this. So when you put your cock and drag but in improper position, what happens? This type of sifting will come into picture and your final product will not be a symmetric one, right? So this is the defect known as a mold sift. So in the mold sift, two parts will not match with each other. It will sift right or left, right? So this is known as a mold sift. So after mold sift, here I mentioned the defect, that is a red tail. So as per the name, when red is walking on the any surface, there will be an impression or projection made by tail. So this type of impression is known as a red tail. So why this defect come into picture? The reason or cause for this defect is the moisture content. So what happens when you pour the hot liquid metal, there will be a moisture in the sand mass. So due to this, it will convert in the vapor and this vapor will condense on the surface of casting, and due to this what happens, there will be a crack form on the surface due to the moisture or liquid particles present on the surface, right? So this type of impression, which is similar as a red tail impression on any surface, that's why it is known as a red tail, right? So I mentioned in this figure a red tail defect which is similar as a tail impression of rat, right? After that I mentioned the blister defect, and blister is nothing but a bump like or bubble shaped defect found on the upper surface of casting. So this defect occurs due to the gas entrapped in between your surface, right? So this is known as a blister. So it is nothing but bubble like bumps found on the surface of the casting, that is known as a blister, right? So it is nothing but spherical bump or spherical impression projection created on the surface of casting, that is known as a blister, right? So there are many defects found on the casting, but our purpose is to avoid these defects while making of any product during casting. So this is all about different defects and different reason or cause for the defect. Thank you all of you.